delighted to say with me now is one of the heroes in 1988, John Scales. At a very important time for Bring the Dons Home. Just tell us about what you've been getting up to this week.
Well, I think I've just been sort of supporting the club. I've looked with interest at how AFC Wimbledon have obviously formed 2002, and then the journey they've been on has been incredible. So I've watched a little bit from afar. I live, you know, very locally, and I've been down to the ground a couple of times, watched a couple of games, and I think it was coming down to the Liverpool game, obviously reminiscent of the great 88 game. And coming into the ground, I was, you know, the butterflies were going a bit, and it was, you know, the excitement of coming to a game that, you know, not that often, I've got to say, going to games these days, so I feel that excitement, and coming in here and knowing what it meant to the players and to Neil Ardley and the fans. Yeah, there's a real excitement about the place and a buzz about how far that journey had been. And so on the playing side and, you know, getting the league status back in 2011, that was fantastic. And the rest of the journey is still to be completed, which is the return home. And I spoke to Eric and a couple of people around the ground and sort of felt just very compelled to offer what little support, what little help I could. And so I said, look, I'll try and raise some awareness about the campaign. It's at a critical stage. Obviously, the planning application has been submitted. Merton Council, it seems, is very receptive to wanting Wimbledon back. We know the way in which the proposition needs to be done with the housing, with the retail side, with the fitness side. You know, the whole project need sustainability, the funding and everything else. And I think the whole plan that I've seen has been incredibly well thought through, very robust. It's tackled all the major issues. You know, it deals with a critical housing need in Merton. You know, it's built on the floodplain, but all that on the technical side, it looks like that's can be addressed. I've spoken to the Environment Agency and, you know, I like to hear things firsthand. So I've done quite a bit of research into it, and I think, you know, rightly you have to always listen to local residents. I think they've been listened to and heard. But similarly, I think any sort of objections, I suppose, have been fully satisfied. So I'm, you know, from one point of view, I've got a very emotional attachment to Wimbledon. They gave me everything in the start of my career, you know, big step when I joined from Bristol Rovers. And of course, winning the 88 Cup final was an incredible moment for me personally, but for the team and the fans. And so that emotional attachment, I suppose, goes right to the heart of what the club is about. The legacy that I was very much proud and privileged to be part of, the group of players, and all that went before, and now, you know, getting back into the Football League, the playing side's done. Now I'm desperate to support the scheme and the plan to come back to Merton. And I, you know, as a resident of Merton, living up in Wimbledon Village, I would be incredibly proud if they came back in to Merton and, you know, got their home back. It's a fantastic plan, you know, thought through on every level. So I don't think, you know, there can be many people that can raise an objection of the legitimacy, I suppose, of Wimbledon coming back home. So very excited about it.
We've seen there, obviously, you're holding up the link to the site.
Yeah.
Yourself, Sophie Hosking, taking to social media this week. There's still time for supporters to get their story across as well about why Wimbledon should return home, isn't there?
Yeah, the important message I've really, you know, got involved with in the last sort of 10 days is to urge local residents specifically, but all football fans generally, to look at bringthedonshome.org, get online, click the yellow button that just says, you know, I'm supportive of this. Even better is obviously to write to the council. I'll be doing the same today, tomorrow, making sure that my voice is heard. One of very many that are incredibly passionate about getting Wimbledon back in the borough.
Absolutely. There's so much that a football club can do these days, isn't there, in modern football? I mean, it's not just about 20 league games and a few cup games at a stadium. It's what it can do within a community, as you're saying, yeah?
It is. I mean, you know, football is one of those unique things that we love watching the game. It's the most popular game in the world, and the heritage, the history of the game and what it does for a community, there's very few things like it. It brings people together. And a football club, I think, especially AFC Wimbledon, absolutely understand their role within the community, what they bring, not just on a match day, as you say, 20 games and maybe, you know, 10 cup games or whatever it may be. But it's their influence within a community, how they bring people together, how they foster that affinity towards having an identity. Merton, I think, can be rightly proud to have a club of the way in which AFC Wimbledon conduct themselves back in the borough. I was always disappointed that we ever left Plough Lane and went to Selhurst Park, you know, 1991. I remember that day very, very clearly, and it was, I don't think I foresaw just where Wimbledon would go, and you know, the whole thing and the journey that we saw go through a very, you know, dark days in many ways, and for the club to be reborn in the way it was and the way in which it was, with the fans coming together. And you know, I've got so many friends when I came down here for the Liverpool game, you know, just meeting everybody, seeing all the familiar faces, as I do in Wimbledon Village and around Wimbledon, and coming to the games. There's a great bond between everybody, and you don't see that often in too many football clubs. It is about the players, it's about the management, about all the support staff, everybody behind the scenes. But most importantly, it's about the fans and what they do and the important element they bring to what everything good about a community is. They show it in abundance, and so I'm glad to be a part of it, proud to be part of it, and would urge everybody to get behind this bid.
You certainly have been. I mean, over the years, you've been really supportive. You've come down here, you've played a part in, of course, playing in the fundraising for the stadium, in the rematch against Liverpool. You've done the old AFC Wimbledon shirt once again.
Yeah.
And also, of course, you opened the main stand extension. So you are very passionate about AFC Wimbledon, aren't you?
I am. And, you know, I'm also an ambassador for the Football Foundation. And the Football Foundation have been, you know, fantastic with the support of facilities within this country. The Football Foundation supported the scheme to extend the stand. Those are sometimes, you know, the great stories, the good stories are often sort of overshadowed by maybe the media these days always focusing on just the playing side or the negativity. But, you know, that's why I think, you know, I'm so happy to support AFC Wimbledon, because of that work in the community, because of the commitment to understand their role within it, because of what it means to so many. And, you know, even here at King's Meadow, it's been great to have AFC here, but we want to be back in Merton. We want to have this new stadium planning permission granted. I urge that, you know, the council do get behind it. They see that it's well thought through, and I think that is down to the residents, the fans, and everybody who have put a great campaign together.
It's the final piece of the jigsaw, basically, isn't it? I mean, it's a remarkable story what's happened in less than 13 years, and with this and with what Neil Ardley's trying to achieve on the pitch as well, it would really top things off, wouldn't it?
Well, it would. It goes, you know, I remember coming when AFC retained their position in the league on that dramatic day just a couple of years ago. And we came to the awards night at the end of the season, and we had the current squad and, you know, everybody celebrating the fact that Football League place had been retained. We had a lot of the 88 boys here, and we had a lot of the 63 FA Amateur Cup winning side. And so it was a unique occasion, you know, just behind us in the stand to get everybody together. And, you know, the heritage, the history of this club is something special. So that was a unique time. Neil Ardley's done a fantastic job. You know, Eric Samuelson, as I said before, the support staff, you know, what makes a club tick, and the efforts of people putting their time and effort to understand what they want to do about a club and how they want to take it forward. It should be admired. It should be looked at as a great example of what football is all about, bringing people together. And I think, you know, AFC Wimbledon is absolutely the epitome of everything good about football. Now, you know, it's just this piece of the jigsaw to get Wimbledon back into the borough. I'm excited about that. Let's keep our fingers crossed that, you know, it gets pushed through, and that we can see the sort of the building blocks started to be put together later this year.
John, it's been an absolute pleasure talking to you. I think it's time to bring the Dons home.
I absolutely agree.